Despite having all the required ammunition, Kings 11 Punjab find themselves at the bottom of the points table, having lost 5 out of their 6 games. Kolkata Knight Riders have also had a very weird kind of a tournament, losing some, winning some. But most important thing is that they're coming into this match after a 10-run win against Chennai Super Kings. And that is the confidence they will be carrying into this match. And things currently are not looking that great for Punjab, because the overall IPL head-to-head between these two teams is heavily towards Kolkata. Out of the 25 matches that they have played, Kolkata Knight Riders have won 17, whereas Punjab has won only 8. Worse, if you see the last 3 matches that these teams have played, all 3 have been won by Kolkata Knight Riders. Now, we also know that Punjab is suffering the most in its bowling department, especially in the death overs. So, what should be Punjab's strategy at the death, and how will Punjab deal with this Sunil Narain factor? Let's discuss this in Strategy Corner. Well, the Kolkata middle order is pretty strong, with heavy names like Owen Morgan, Andre Russell, even Dinesh Karthik. All of them, it's a good mix. But all the 3 players that I named, I have actually been susceptible to the short ball, that is the bouncer, and that too from really fast balls. Now, Punjab has to go to Shami and has to ask him to bowl fast and bowl good bouncers at them. The only problem that could arise would be that Russell has got the better of Shami. He has scored 84 runs off 31 balls and has been dismissed only once. But on the brighter side, Shami has dismissed Morgan once, but Morgan has played only 5 balls and has been dismissed. So that could be a positive point. And you also have to remember that Shami is still Kings 11 Punjab's best bet against the Knight Riders' power-packed middle order. Narain was reserved for the death against Mahendra Singh Dhoni in the last match. But in this match, he might take the new ball, because Rahul has a strike rate of 231 against him, but Gail has been susceptible against Narain. He has less than 100 strike rate. He has just scored 153 runs in 177 balls against Narain, and he has been dismissed 5 times. Also, Mayank Agarwal has his own issues with Sunil Narain, because he has just scored 19 runs of 16 balls and has been dismissed once. Now, one thing is very clear, that Chris Gayle is definitely going to come to the top order of Kings 11 Punjab. But who will he replace in the team? Also, do you remember that in 2011, 9 years younger Gayle had weaved a magic for Royal Challengers Bangalore? Out of the 5 matches that RCB had played, out of their first 5 matches, they had won just one, and it was a similar kind of a situation. Dark Nanis was injured, Chris Gayle came in the first match against Kolkata Knight Riders itself. In fact, Gayle had scored a century and won that match for RCB. And that was not the only match. After that, RCB won 7 consecutive matches in a row. Well, if you can pull out the same feat for Punjab, then Punjab definitely will have a look at the playoff spot. But will he be able to do it? And most importantly, what will be the team composition of Punjab? And should KKR change anything in the winning combination? To know more, where do we go? Well, simple. Let's head over to the Predicted 11 section. Well, in the Predicted 11, I think, as I already mentioned, with KL Rahul, I'm putting in Chris Gayle. Chris Gayle, I think, will be coming in place of Glenn Maxwell. Maxwell has scored just 48 runs in 6 innings. 2020, there is also one more problem. The last time Gayle had played was in January in Bangladesh Premier League. After that, he pulled out of Caribbean Premier League because of his personal reason, and in the first few matches of Punjab, he hasn't featured. So the match exposure for him isn't there. But he's Chris Gayle, he can do anything on his day. So one down will be Mayank Agarwal, then Prabhsimran Singh, then Nicholas Puran, who was fantastic, Mandeep Singh, Mujibur Rahman, Ravi Vishnoi, Mohammad Shami. I am bringing in Chris Jordan in place of Sheldon Cottrell. And my reason is very simple. Mujibur Rahman, Ravi Vishnoi, Mohammad Shami, Arshdeep Singh and Sheldon Cottrell, none of them can bat. So you basically have just six batters and five complete bowlers. And Sheldon Cottrell hasn't even been that effective. So now if I bring in Chris Jordan, what effectively happens is, I might still not have a very good bowler. He might go for runs, but at least he can give me a few runs. He can support. Last match, Nicholas Puran couldn't take the match away. One of the reasons being there was no other batsman to support him at the other end. So that would be very important. And of course, Arshdeep Singh. Arshdeep Singh showed a lot of promise in the last match. And I think among the pacers, at least he was the best bowler in the last match. And Arshdeep and Bishnoi, remember, were the bowlers who changed the match around and took Punjab to a position where they could at least think of winning. So KL Rahul and Nicholas Puran have a very interesting pattern to their batting. KL Rahul has scored 350 plus in scores in this year's IPL. And all of them have come when Punjab has batted first. In three innings, when Punjab has batted first, Rahul has scored 264 runs in 175 balls at an average of 132 and at a strike rate of 150.86. But when Punjab has chased, in three innings, Rahul has just scored 49 runs in 54 balls at an average of 16.33 and a strike rate of 90.74. So clearly, whenever Punjab has chased, Rahul has found it a little difficult to, pace his innings, probably because of the run rate pressure. Puran, on the other hand, is exactly the opposite of that. Puran has fared well whenever Punjab has chased. When Kings 11 Punjab has batted first, in 3 innings, Puran has scored 75 runs in 43 balls at an average of 37.50 and at a strike rate of 174.42. But when Punjab has batted second, in 3 innings, Puran has scored 121 runs in 67 balls at an average of 40.33 and a strike rate of 180.60. So it will be very interesting to see how does KKR bowlers contend them, and also if they can change the stats around a little in this match. Now moving on to the Kolkata Knight Riders team. Well, why would you change a winning combination? And thankfully, there are no injuries. So I don't think Kolkata has too much to worry about. So they'll have the same combination. Last match, Sunil Narayan had come at number 4. As a pinch hitter, which worked because Chennai doesn't have express pace bowlers, so they weren't able to attack Sunil Narayan with the fast short balls. But that's not the case with Punjab. Even though Punjab bowlers haven't bowled well, but they have express pace in Mohammad Shami. So it'll be better not to use Sunil Narayan the batter that early. And the most interesting battle would be Pat Cummins versus Chris Gayle. My star player of the match will be Ravi Vishnoi. So I will put it very simply, if Gayle is playing, then it's Punjab. If Gayle is not playing, then it's Kolkata Knight Riders. Well, that's my prediction. What is your prediction? Let us know in the comment section in YouTube, Facebook and Instagram. Also, please like, share and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Like and follow us on Facebook. Follow us on Instagram. And keep joining us for the previews and reviews of all the IPL matches. Till the next time, bye-bye.